When I was first asked to host Saturday Night, they called me in California to tell me how I happened to be able to produce All in the Family, Maude, Sanford and Son, Good Times, One Day at a Time, The Jeffersons, The Nancy Walker Show, All's Fair, Mary Hartman. And of course, well, you can do that. That's all right. I won't accept that for myself, but for the vast family of writers, producers, directors, everybody that contributes to the making of all those shows. But a lot of people do help. But you see, the question that all of the people who work on this show, the actors in particular, wanted to ask me about, they've heard about the various tiffs. You know, the press has printed so much about the various tiffs and arguments that go on among hardworking professionals in our field. And of course, we have had our differences. But the actors on this show really wanted to know how I got along with the actors on the shows with which I'm involved. So I decided to do my own piece of investigative journalism. And I went directly to all of those actors that I work with, and I asked them, what do they really think
about
me?
Working with you is a joy, and it's perfectly, totally harmonious. And if we have any disagreement, we always find a compromise, and it's just wonderful.
I don't want to prod you, but in terms of talent.
Talent? You mean mine?
No, I was...
Oh, yours.
Because they were asking about...
Oh, of course. I think you're the most talented producer, writer, and not only that, you have the gift to direct, too.
I can't thank you enough.
Norman, you're welcome.
And it was so kind of you to talk to me.
You're welcome.
Tonight.
Goodbye.
Thank you. That was my very dear friend, Gene Stapleton, answering the question posed for me, how do people work and feel about working with
them? The many testimonials that you've had up to now, has anybody ever used the word genius?
Well,
I mean, you're a genius. We don't have to elongate this. You are a genius. And everybody around you says so. Has anybody used in connection with yourself the word taste?
Well, frankly, I've
Let me be the first, then. What about humility? Because, you know, all the producers that I've ever worked with are constantly getting their names and faces plastered in the public prints. And here is a man who, for a change, a pleasant change, stays constantly in the background.
I can't tell you. I can't tell you how much I thank you for those words.
No.
Ladies and gentlemen, my very dear friend and co-worker, Carol O'Connor.
Norman, I understand that Saturday Night Live, incidentally, I feel that we can call you Norman, although we are the newest members of the Norman Lear family.
Of course.
I understand that they would like us to kind of express what we feel about you as a person, as a human being.
Yes, and I just let me interrupt to say that I've talked to a number of the others in the companies, you know, a number of the other actors and so forth, and everybody's been just so kind and frankly, extremely complimentary. I want to openly invite your criticism.
Criticism?
I honestly can't think. In the commune here, we have a saying. I mean, it's Saint Norman. I mean, I don't know who said that to you, you know, to your face.
Richard, there's no way I can convey my appreciation.
Every time I look at those eyes, I just want to cry.
Sincerity, honesty, truth.
Warm and kindness.
Forgive me,
we just love you so much, Norman.
Thank you,
Norman. We love you so much.
Thank you, Richard.
Norman. Good luck. Continue good luck, Norman.
Thank you very much. My dearest friends, newest friends, Richard Crennan, Bernadette Peters, speaking to me about how they feel about working with me.
You're just, I don't know, one of the kindest, gentlest people I know.
Thank you. Thank you, Nancy. Very much.
My pleasure to know you.
That was Nancy Walker talking frankly and sincerely about how she feels about working with me. So I'm grateful for that. I too will continue to work.
For one thing, I want to give you all the praise in the world for such a beautiful show the Jeffersons, the way the Jeffersons are, and how you treat us all the same, all of us.
Then you'd say, Isabel and Sherman, that there is no race line in TAT and Tandem.
Of course not. I've never even toyed with the idea.
Well, that is so comforting to hear, and especially pleasant to hear in the light of this journalistic investigation on behalf of NBC Saturday Night. Thank you so much. I've been talking to my good friends, Isabel and Sanford, and who have been addressing us particularly on the nature of the relationships, the blacks and shows, and those television shows.
Norman, has anybody mentioned the incredible humility and modesty that, you know, that you possess?
Which... Frankly, Beatrice, yes, it has been mentioned,
yes.
Somewhat.
I mean, has anybody discussed the way you can, what can I call it, grace under fire?
Well, no, that hasn't come up. I do recall something like that having been said about Jack Kennedy, but no, not about me.
You are perfect. I mean, you are a husband, a father, you are to me everything.
Beatrice,
and I thank you.
Arthur, I bless you for those words.
Thank you.
I know how much they come from a full heart, and I thank you so much.
Thank you, darling. Thank you.
That was my dear friend, Beatrice Arthur. I must say in conclusion that I've always considered myself a modest and unassuming man. And to have all of that affirmed in this incredible way by all of the wonderful people that I've talked to. So very heartwarming. I'm happy to have had the opportunity to share this with all of you.